Draco here, and today we are taking the Modern Merfolk to another run, and we wanted to spin the same deck we did last time, the No Spells Merfolk, but this time we just are nudging up a bit on Old Border nostalgia. I'm just in general really a big fan of Old Border. I've been playing since before they changed the border, in 7th or 8th edition, I think it was. And I just love the fact that you can play some of the new cards with Old Border. So I tuned the deck, but primarily to have more Old Border stuff, just because I think it's really nice. Merfolk is actually a pretty nice deck to run when you want to play Old Border. You can see it here. First of all, we of course are playing a lot of basic lands, which comes in Old Border. So we have these islands here, and I like these ones. They are originally printed in Revised. Alpha. So this is like the first original art for islands, and they've been printed also in Revised. I have them in Revised in paper, so I play them when I play. Then we also, I actually adjusted the one drop so I could play Rich Dad Dockhand with Old Border. I don't know what's best, Kush Catcher or Rich Dad Dockhand if you want to run one drops, but someone told me that Rich Dad Dockhand has been doing pretty well, so I got him in because it's Old Border primarily. I did manage to get Tide Tapers, but they can also be found in Old Border. I have them in paper in Old Border. I have them in paper, hang on. You can see it right here. I have them in paper in Old Border. Ooh. Right here. Really nice. I don't have them in the deck here, but I also, you can also sometimes play Focus Recall, which is also an original and old card. Let's see, I have a hook trigger here, we can't really see it that much. But really nice. But unfortunately I didn't get those. But I did get, Masters in Old Border, Master of the Pearl Trident in Old Border. Of course, Love Atlantis in Old Border. That's one of the original. Once I have them in 4th edition in my Merfolk deck here. All 4th edition, so in the paper form. And then we have, of course, Svealun, you can get in Old Border. It's really nice. And for this deck, you can also get Dismembers in Old Border. And I actually like the art here. Like, look really cool in Old Border, I think, this one. I love me some Old Border action. And one of the other things we can get in Old Border is Chalice of the Void. I also have them in Old Border in paper. Where are they? They are right here. See here. Old Border and paper. Love me some Old Border paper magic here. So let's get into the run. And we already did one of the games, which was a close loss. So we are 0-0. But let's get back and get a 4-1. That would be really nice. And we'll be right back for round 2. In it here. 2 red MTG. And we unfortunately lost the die roll. Let's see if we get a good starting hand, and before we get going, I wanted just to mention, of course, my sponsor, Card Hoarder, which allows me to play all these nice Merfolk decks. Card Hoarder is a service where you can buy cards, and they'll deliver it direct to your MTG account. And you can also rent in their loan service, so it's a really nice system. And this hand here is absolutely fine. We have something to do on one with the Dismember. Old Border Dismember, I love this. And then we can play a couple of things on 2. Probably just running out the adept here. Oh, okay, I thought he was about to play the Ragavan. Then the Dismember would have been nice. But definitely, since we draw another island, we're definitely gonna keep the Gladful Mimic in hand. We might be able to dismember something, or later we can copy something with the mimic. So, because he didn't play out the hex, okay, now that's interesting. Tideshaper could be interesting here, and better than the adept. I think it actually is. He'll just kill it now, but I think it's still fine. Maybe actually the adept would have been better. And we can use this later to get unblockable. But maybe we can do some mana denial. Hmm. two red MTG. And get to take out the stomping ground. Maybe he'll kill it in response. Yeah, he does. I was expecting that. That's why I think he actually should have went for the added play instead. Oh, Dariah. Okay, we can kill that with dismember. We don't have any more lands. Do we still want to kill it with the dismember? What are we up against here? I think that's a good dismember side. Let's just get that out there, right? I think we want to kill it and then maybe just play the adept, because normally if this is like something like I expect it to be Titan Shift or something. If they don't have any more. They don't really have that much targets that I can counter for Renesics. Maybe Scapeshift next turn, but they don't have a land, so I think I'll just run out the Adept. Let's go the Master. Xayadun is nice. Let's kill off the Dryad. Yeah, let's just do that. That doesn't really do anything right now, but I think it's fine just to get it out there. There's a Valakut. If there's another Light Bolt for the Adept, that would be absolutely fine. Okay, so... maybe the Svealun is just a really good play. Now I think I want to run up the Glasgow Mimic. He could be potentially be playing Scapeshift next turn. But that doesn't really matter that much. It's not that good to play a Scapeshift here. I could also just play out the Glasgow Mimic, copy the Adept, but I think it's better to play out Svealun. Should I attack first? Svealun could be a handful for him. Normally they don't have that much ways of killing it. The next turn, Primeval Titan could come out, of course, then I'm in trouble. And he does have a Valakut. So I think I want to take out the Valakut, actually. That would be a pretty nice play. And I'm just holding up the Hex Catcher. Another Svealun is fine. Okay. He should have been on 15 if you played the last turn correctly. And now I just want to hold up the Hex Catcher, I think. It's better just to get out the Titan. Or the Master. Oh, let's hold up the Hex Catcher. I can potentially sack three things. Spell, let that happen. Now we have an island on his side. Dryad. Another Valakut. Three points of damage. We can play out the Hex Catcher here, and then our turn, we can, oh, that's pretty good, because only 3 mana, we can play down this one. What about attacking with this one as well? It's 5, 7, doesn't really add to the clock. the drive doesn't really do that much. So I think it's better just to... Maybe it's better just to attack with Mutavault. Let's just hold up a Tara. Another Hexcat here. That's pretty good draw, because then I have something to do if I don't have two Tavara. Should also add in this turn, maybe. Titan Shift. Titan Shift. Since it's Titan Shift, I want to get down the subtleties. Maybe Flusterm, are they good? I don't think they are. But Hexguys are definitely good. Harbingers are not good either. They're not going to attack, so we can take those one out. Duggan could be decent. Dismembers is also good to kill off the Dryad. So I think they want, I want them actually in there. How good is Dark Hand? Can slow him down a bit, but is that worth it? Don't think it is. I think definitely Subtlety is good. It's good here. This is one of the hands that's really bad against a way of killing off the Idavile, but I think it's worth it. I'll keep it. We're on the draw, so we can also draw lands. They need to do an old border version of Idavile. That would be nice. Ooh, the land is perfect. Let's run out this one. Naming Merfolk. That's a perfect draw. And we have the Subtlety up and running. Grow Spiral, that's fine. Valakut, okay. Let's get a count on this Idavile here. Dismember, okay, so we have that up and running. I think it's fine just to run out this dude here. And just show them our master, that's fine. Another edit, that's also decent. With all the card events we are getting here, I'm considering if it's worth it to... What's this now? I think it's interesting they start running the blue one. Okay, I can dismember that my turn, but he does get to play a card here. Is it better to subtlety it? I think it might be. I think it might be, yeah. We'll just remove the trickster. It's a matter of tempo, this. We should consider running out this one, the adept here, to get a land in. Yeah, see if we can draw a land here. Did not, but we did draw a tight here, but that's pretty good. We can take his green source, then he can replay it. So I like that play. And we still have the subtlety up if he finds a green source. Of course, he can kill off the tide here, but I think it's pretty nice to do that. And I'm saving the subtlety for the next Primeval Titan. Ouch. That's a really good fire. Here we could consider... I think I want to just... use it here. Get in the... Get in the master. No, get in the edit. I need to draw a card. Oof, perfect. And now I put a trigger on here so we can get up to subtlety range. And we might tie Tipper again. The other green source. We are missing out on the chance to play the master from the vial here, but I think we're better to get it up. Okay. Denying his green mana from the tide ship. I think that's an interesting strategy we're doing, but I think it might work. Now I can finally play it. And that's a problem, actually. So I have to subtlety here. It's annoying, I have to do this here. So we can kill him, hit him for 8 here. That's enough. Oh, that's a crazy game. Okay, we are back for round number 3. Dirk Mantooth, our opponent. And it seems like we got a hand without any lands here. We on the draw. I can't keep this mulligan. This is better, but not good. I think we'll have to keep it anyways. Send back a trickster in the dark, maybe. Now let's put back a lord. Maybe we should get the original hand. Another Ketria Triumph. Okay. Great draw here. But I think I'll probably want to trickster next turn. Let's just play out the Boro. Okay, so we need to find a hex catcher. I think this could be Rin 6, so yeah. It could be a number of decks, but of course, Rune 6 in itself is not so good for us. It goes up to 4. It's one turn too late here. Do I want to play out? I think it's better to play out the Trickster. A surprise. Also utilizing my mana for the best. It's getting a lot of value from the Rune 6 early here. Right, okay, we can dismember that. It's pretty good. Now I'll do this in response so we can play that again. So we tap this one down, now he won't be able to play it again. That's really nice for us. Ooh, Hexcatcher, that's pretty neat as well. I wanna just remember the... Do I wanna just remember the Dryad here? Or play out the Duck Hand? Definitely wanna attack the Trickster on Rune 6. Yeah, we wanna kill the Dryad now. I'm just gonna hold up Hexcatcher here. allowing us to potentially sacrifice. Yeah, we don't want to do anything against that. But that's a good card here. Expedient Iteration is such a nice card. Almost want to, makes me want to splash splash red, right? But it's not the right way to go. And of course, guys, as always, if you enjoy the content, please like the video. It means a lot. And subscribe to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/c/dracoing. I am nearing 700 subscribers at the moment, and I'm feeling really good about it. So it's pretty nice. Fire nice. Killing that one. So a countering it doesn't really matter. Doesn't really change anything. That's okay, because I'll be able to kill off the Renesex next turn anyways. Because I can play down this one here. And then I can attack. Increases on Renesex. The question if it's better to get the hand out here. I think it's better to get the hand out. So we have something we can sack potentially. Maybe it's just better to get the either vial out. Well, let's get this one out. The Hex Catchers, of course, open here, but it was a nice play to get the Renesex off the board. These are a lot of cards, man. Another Renesex. Yeah, that's not good. Then you can kill out the Hex Catcher. Wouldn't mind drawing a land because then we can play Svelun and having it indestructible. That's fine. I think I'd rather want to just place Valoon here instead of attacking with the Mudaval. That's also a line. So we're just gonna attack with the Dark Hand. And he has Sidewalk. So nothing to do. Uncountable Valoon, that's indestructible. Should be pretty good here. And now that Duck Hand's toughness actually comes into play really relevantly here. If that was a Curse Catcher, he could kill it off with the Renesex and then he could kill Svelun. But the Svelun needs to do something here. Look at this old border action here. Love it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If it doesn't have anything more here, we need to be aware what that could mean. Let's just play down the Mudavolt first. When I set one of the Mudavolts, should do that definitely. So this one is in control. No reason. I don't think this. Is there any reason to tap down a land in his turn? That one. There might be. I don't think there is. I think I'm just gonna attack. Him. Renesex. And him. Tattoo, that's pretty nice. We will get to kill off the right rent, the one here. Now we're just gonna take out Velikut. And I think I'm just gonna hold up activation. Either one doesn't really make any sense to play now. And I'd rather be able to activate a Mudavolt, so I can get in this work with Svelun. If he plays a skip shift here, we're done for, but I don't think we could have done anything about escape shifts. Yeah, it looks like escape shift. What could we have done against that? Nothing. That's unfortunate. If we would have drawn here instead of the Tachiba, we could have drawn the Hex Catcher. That'd be pretty nice. But here, I think I'm playing against a lot of Scape Shift decks these days here. Okay, that's fair enough. He got us with the Scape Shift. And we won against Scape Shift. I think it's... Aren't they also running Titans? Am I just being wrong on that straight up? I think they're both running Scape Shift and Titan. So, in that case, I want the Subtleties in there. I don't know if Flusterstorm is worth it against Scape Shift. It could be. Harping is definitely not worth it. I don't know, even know if Richard and Duck Hand is worth it, but maybe just tapping down and slowing them a bit could be nice. Flusterstorm. I think Exit Flusterstorm is pretty decent. They have a mini spell so we can counter. Dismembering the Triad is also valuable. But is it that good? I want to cut down. You know, 3 Subtleties, 2 Dismembers. Then we can cut a couple of Lords, I think. Or the Duck Hands, maybe. Yeah, let's just cut the Duck Hands. Tricks are fine because they can tap down the Dryad. Okay, start here. It's a keyboard hand, it's not a great hand. Penny Mulligans, that's nice. Oh, of course, I don't wish misfortune on my opponent, but it's not the worst that he's not necessarily having a dream start. I need to, maybe I just play out a Lord instead and we can win and 6 it. I think that's better. Is it better? Then just bolt it, right? I think that's better. Especially because I have 2 Lords. I think it's better to run out a Lord. I really don't want to use my Solitude yet if I don't have to. He could easily have Lightning Bolt, but then again, then he used a good removal spell. It is a Lightning Bolt, okay. They place a Ren 6 now, what do I actually do? I think that's a solid hit. It's just a bad momentum swing now. He'll just draw it again and shoot my adept. But if he replays it and I have a Lord out and a Moodle all out, then I think that's better. Because this allows me to put out a Moodle Vault. Let's see what he does with it here. Bottom. Okay, maybe he has one more. Definitely get out of the Moodle Vault here. Maybe it's better just to add it because then I at least know I can get it out. Too many lands. I think the correct line would have been to add it early and then letting me run at 6 and then I could solitude it there instead. No, it's because he had one more. But if he kills it now, I can kill off the Moodle Vault. With the Moodle Vault? Yeah. I could play down the Lord first. Is that better? No, let's play out the Lord first. get the Rune 6 off the board. I think it's important to get that off the board, because it's a big card advantage engine for him, getting all these lands back. This Rune 6 can get back at land, but can kill off the Lord here, and we have a lot of attackers. Yeah, okay, so now the land is actually not the worst. We can play out Svealoon and still attack with Mutavault. So if he doesn't have a removal spell for the Lord, the Rune 6 goes away. He probably does have it. Potentially just Fire and Ice here. Nice that they're using Fire and Ice. I like that card. That's also actually one of the cards that's been printed in Old Border. Now we're talking about Old Border. Ooh, Growth Spiral, that's a lot better for me. Oh, no Lightning Bolt. Okay, nice. I like the situation here. So this means that we can put out Svealoon. I'm attacking him or the Rune 6. Maybe I should consider attacking him now for 5 damage. Instant 10. It's better to kill off the Rune 6 because it's not getting him closer. It's getting him closer to lethal, but it's not lethal in the next swing either way. But of course now I can see the Rune 6 has been doing a lot of action here. You can see I really need, in this matchup, I really need the Force Negation, which this deck is not running. I had a guy commenting on the lack of Force Negation in the YouTube chat. I think it was Dan who made the comment, and I think he just said that sometimes the Force Negation is just a really good effect, and it is, especially against a deck like these here. Okay, and now he has to pay the ward. Okay, it's definitely. Definitely in it here. Exactly, that's pretty nice. Should we can both attack with Mutavault. I think it's better to attack with Svealoon. Through draw. Yeah, perfect. Perfect, perfect. Revealing the Svealoon here, drawing a card. Drawing the Lord is nice, but I think I need the Hexcatcher up now. And I can both set Adept, Mutavault, and Hexcatcher. And Svealoon potentially, if it's E resolve the skip shift here. Dryad. Mm-hmm. Velikit. Yes. So nice play by him. We do have a little trick up our sleeve here. A bit of Modalion Hexcatcher action. And let's just put this one down here. I think I need to. He could have something like Mystical Dispute, so I want to do it like this. I just have to kill him as fast as possible before he draws his combo win. The Lord of Villains here was great, getting unblockable. Okay. That's actually the line. Maybe we should have played the island before we attacked, because what if we drew a Hexcatcher? Then we could have flipped that in. It's a 3-outer. But it's worth thinking about. I was just thinking that if I draw a Mutavault, I want to play that after. The thinking is pretty interesting. Mm-hmm. will you find when they are taking this long to find it out? Dress down. Okay. That's scary. Pretty scary. He only has one blue source. No, of course, the dryad is there. So the big question is if I run a, want to counter the dress down. The big decisions, big decisions. I think it's cool that there's a Velikut deck here with blue, but I actually think this this deck is not running the Primeval Titans. I've never seen it. Maybe he just wants to cycle the dress down now. What can he play for two mana here? I don't think I need to counter this, so I'll just let it happen. I could have countered by sacking Mudavolt, Lord of Atlantis, and Redelling Hedgekitcher. He didn't find it. Perfect. Okay, so 1-1. We're not seeing that. I think it's better maybe just to have the Mystical Spoon in there. I think it's... Man, that's crazy. But maybe the Solitudes are decent enough to take out the early Rain 6. As we did here, that worked out. Maybe that's worth it. But you haven't seen the Primeval Titans. I think it's like a new variant of the deck where you play Titan Shift Splashing Blue for value cards. Let's just run this back. I wish I could draw a hand with either vial. Can't really argue a mulligan here. Frustrating that we can't counter the Hexcatcher with the Hexcatcher here. I just think that was a mistake. We should probably play the Mudavolt against the Ren 6. Okay, he doesn't have the Ren 6. Then he's probably have a Fire and Ice and want to tap down my land in upkeep. So let's draw one drop here. Oh, we can actually play the Hexcatcher in response. That's pretty neat. If he does that, we can... No, we can't, of course, because we only have one land. I think it's going to come in now. He's going to tap down the cavern. What are we going to do then? Hopefully draw one drop. Come on. Okay, we drew the Master. It's not a one drop. But I think I want to play the Mudavolt, giving me the option of attacking. I really like that Hexcatcher just makes Mudavolts better. I really feel it here. Okay, Dryad. Can't do much about that. I gotta say, I think here comes either one. That's a little late. So we have a couple of lines. What is he gonna do here? He's not gonna play Scapeshift yet, right? He can play two lands. That's five. So it makes no sense. I'm considering either should I either vial and hold up Hexcatcher or just play out the Sphaerloon. I think I just need to play out the Sphaerloon here. And then next turn I could double spell. The vial would be good to get out, but I think it's not fast enough. And can he really kill off the Sphaerloon? I haven't seen a Fury yet. And what am I going to counter with Hexcatcher with only one out? The either vial is so valuable when you have so many 2-drops. But it's just going to get so slow to get up and running. I think I have to ignore the Etherwile and just play out this Sphaerloon. I feel I'm behind. Next turn we can double spell Hexpatch and add it, and it's pretty nice. And even though we have subtleties in the deck, I think I still want to be able to have uncounterable threats here. Okay, not something that's too good here, bro. Engineered for two. Okay. That is pretty good. I'm glad I didn't go for the other line. So he's just ready to take out our creatures. Oh, I have a great line here. So imagine... is that worth it? Okay. Okay, so... what happens if I play the master and attack? He might crack the engineer to kill the master. And then I play the Bodalian Hexcatcher when he blocks the Dryad. I bait him into doing that. What happens if I play the attack and he blocks the Hexcatcher? I think it's better to play the master and then play Hexcatcher afterwards. So I'm just gonna name Merfolk here. And then I'm gonna play out the master. Granting me unblockable here. So if he cracks the engineering growth, he gets to draw here. Yes. If he blocks now. He doesn't want to block. Maybe this was a mistake here. He can never solve the scapeshift, right? Scapeshift is hard to play against. Okay, so that's one. And that's what we do against this. We can't get it indestructible. This is not the worst you could be doing. We have to get rid of the dryad in some way. I don't think he had that much more going on for him. That was pretty nice of him. I don't know if I should have played that differently, but yeah. This could be a Ren 6. Oh no. No. They did have the scape shift. Now we don't have anything left here. Can't even draw. Can only ask him to pay one mana. This sucks. I think this matchup is difficult here, without the fortifications. Yes, yes. Now I got it. GG, well played. And we're off to the last round here. Should have had, we should have got all the dismembers in there. But let's see if we can bounce back in round four. Okay. We're back here for round number four. Only 1-2, but that's okay. We have cool old border cards like the dismember here. Svealu, old border looks so nice. And we're gonna keep this hand. It's fine. One of the things I've found is that it's like this Temur scapeshift here is a really nice version of the deck. That's a really, really cool version of the deck. And that's what we've been playing against. And for me, that's kind of a new thing. Maybe I'm just no, not in it. Oh my, is it really the mirror? If the mirror, then we have a better start. But I think also that Merfolk is getting stronger. He does have the force negation though. We have this member's main deck. Blast Zone version of the deck. Pretty cool. I don't know even if it's this dismember yet. Here, I think even though I could be hex catching something, I don't think it's worth it. I think it's better to play out the shore here, holding up dismember. I had my buddy Wolf Fungus ratting me on the interwebs. Oh my god, that's so unfortunate for him. We have the dismember here. Wolf Fungus showed me this really nice version of the deck because he said that I should try it out. And I think that's because he did a trophy with it. And it's a more like a control-y flash-based version where you also play Brineborn Cutthroat. So looks pretty neat. But maybe that's not it here because I don't think they're running. Maybe it's just there was this version as well as that was just called Shadow of Seen Sky that ran almost no Merfolks. Okay, not drawing a land here means that I think I want to still do this and this. Get out the Svealu again. Yes, yes, it's fine. Two cards in hand for him, so if he can't handle the Svealu better than the bounce, I think I'm in pretty good shape. Another Svealu. We can double order our Svealu. And I think we win the race. He does have an island out, so that's perfect. I think it's worth it just to go for it. Maybe just one actually, because that's the wrong one. I'm just gonna play out the hex catch as well. I should have played the other one. Doesn't matter, I should have. Wouldn't have blocked anyways. But he has to find something here because I can also double order again next turn. I just put in the hex catch for 1 point of damage. I don't think it's gonna be relevant. The stack he's on so few cards. Always when you play the mirror, the mirror-ish cards, remember that Lord gives red folks unblockable on your turn. So you can put one Plascon on and kill it on the next turn. So he evokes this. We just place it. Oh, he has to evoke it. Why don't you play it? Oh, because you don't want to blast zone it. Okay, that's fair. So if we play one more, he's dead, right? Six. That's five. Ten. No, no, he's not dead if we play one more. And if he blast zones next turn. If he blast zones. It's not enough. Why did he kill it here? I think it's better just to. I think I put it on the bottom actually. So we're gonna put the charge counter on the blast zone now. Then he can kill off all two drops. I want to do that now, and then I can double master again. If I want to take a card first. Should have put it on the bottom. This is really smart by him here. He's holding it. He's gonna do it in my turn. Actually getting quite close to this. Now he has to do it here. Trickster. Hopping, and what a great draw. What a great draw. Kind of lucky here, gotta say. So this happens. Then he goes to one. Then we can hopping on his Sphere Doom. And play another Master. So, I think we played it too cleanly, but I think we managed to pull it out. But it's a nice deck, tempo based. Yeah, I think they're also running. Definitely want to see. I think they're running a lot of different creatures as well. The Daniel click sometimes as well. Maybe the sources could be good. Mystical Speech is definitely amazing here. Sources are good. Maybe the Harpoons are nice. I think Sailor is decent. Dismembers are good. I don't like Dark Hand that much. What can Hexcatch actually counter? Maybe we just cut. We should cut a couple of lords. I don't think we're still the most aggressive, more aggressive deck. Maybe the tricks are not as interesting. We should cut down on a two drop, so I think it's fine to cut down the lords. We just want to have one more extra. One more extra salty. Yeah, this is fine. Don't want too many two drops. Not too many two drops, no. Because of Blasso. Oko Dio. I'll keep this hand. It's a pretty nice, pretty decent to have turn one Tide Shiver. It's pretty decent to have Cavern Souls. He didn't see that. So he might have missed a little dispute, stuff like that. So here we play out Cavern and have an uncounterable Tide Shiver. Merfolk. Did we get in this salty, by the way? But then I maybe want to mention salty for Kevin when I can do it. Here there's an argument if you just bring out a Harbinger on 2. So we can have an Instructable Svelum, but Instructable Svelum doesn't really matter against him. He's gonna bounce it instead. Okay, let's see what can happen here. I think Tyship on 2 is just as good as a Harbinger on 2, then we can resolve our Mood Evolve. Let's start by attacking. There's no need to not just attack. No reason not just to get in there. It's not really ready to remove this Hall of Storm Giants, but I think it's okay. Maybe should have done it. Okay, he's gonna bounce that one. Yeah, fine. So at least he used that bounce spell on the Tideshipper. And not on the Svelum that's coming in now on counterball. I'm gonna attack first. He can counter it, and he just used his bounce. Maybe he has one more Brazen Borrow. Yeah, he has. No, he just played it. Perfect. That's good for us. We don't want to get that back to his hand with Harbinger. Fairy Conclave. He might as well attack. He didn't draw any of Blast Zones this turn. This game here. Member. Yeah, that's of course annoying, but it's okay. Trickster is pretty good. I think I just want a Trickster. And I could attack with the Mood Evolve or just play a Harbinger. Running out of Harbinger saying no is pretty nice. I want a Trickster. So I can't run out the Harbinger. In that case, if I want a Trickster, I think I should tie Chipper. And I'll play this and say Merfolk again. I think I can raise his Castle Vantra, so I think I wanna take out the Call of the Storm Giants. Slowly but controlled, grinding him down. He's on 10 now. Brazen B is getting in there, but it's going to be stopped in its tracks here. I think I just want to stall it. Okay, so it didn't want to do it anymore. So that's pretty nice. We are 2-2 in the league, and let's see if we can finish up with a bang here. It was actually a pretty fast run we're doing. Really, really nice. And let me know, by the way, in the chat, I wanted to settle that. Do you enjoy old border cards like we talked about here? The theme of today has been old border. And what is your favorite of these new retro frames card that they did? I can say for myself that I have a couple of favorites. For example, of course, I showed you the Svealun and the other cards there. But one of the things I really like as well is the, because yeah, they did this Goblin Guide retro frame. I think that's pretty cool. And I actually just recently bought myself a capture map, so I can use that in my old border cube. So let me know in the chat, what's your favorite retro frame card? Rhapsidian in the last game here, let's see if we can get 3-2. This hand is absolutely junk. But actually, this is kind of so one of the hands we can actually keep because of either bar. So let's do that. We're on the play even, so. Just only non-blue mana source generators. Oh my god, it's in Yawgmoth. Okay, don't want to pick Yawgmoth. Would be nice to draw a blue source here. So we can resolve the Hexcatcher if needed. Rev City. Okay, no bueno. Then we might as well just attack here. So the best way of getting making sure that you attack with the right Mudavolt is that when you right click on it, you can see if it's newly controlled. And if it's newly controlled, you just say, okay, that's fine, then I'll use that to generate a mana, and then you can get in on the other one. So if he kills off my Aether Vial, I think we we're so far behind. But I don't think he necessarily can. It looks like it's Yawgmoth. I think they're also playing Twilight Mire. Yeah, Stringwood Geist. That's absolutely fine. I actually like... Okay, no attacks. Interesting. You want to be able to block my Moodlord maybe? Hopefully draw land here. No land. I think it's better to just hold up. The option of using Hexcatcher. Here we can both use Hexcatcher activating the Mudavolt sacking it. We can use Dismember. We can put in a Bedalia Hexcatcher, or Trickster, or Harbinger. So we have a lot of options. Let's see what it does here. If there's something that's important that we want to counter. I think I'd rather want a second a Mudavolt than a Lord. Even though that sounds crazy. Rouse Messenger. Okay, that's actually not the worst. Because we can just bounce that. With the Harbinger. Oh, he gets value, but he also used his entire turn on that, so it's actually fine. I really want to draw the blue source. So I can both resolve a Hexcatcher and we're gonna keep this in two. And something else. No luck here. Question if I wanna attack. The trick would be to put in a master. Then I can't counter anything. I think it's still better to do that. And of course he's not gonna block. So now we have a Trickster, we have a Hexcatcher, we have a double Mudavolts, and some Masters. This Aether Vial is really getting its value back in spades. Gotta say, it's nice. Oh my god. Prosperous Innkeeper. Okay. So it's like this, I think it's like this weird combo deck. Prosperous. How does it work? It isn't Yawgmoth they're using it. Just to gain life or what? Okay. I'll definitely start by just allowing it, seeing what happens. Let's take a lot of damage from these speed lanes here. Grist, and that's a perfect counter target. No, and I can't counter that, of course. I will keep forgetting that. What do I do then? I should definitely trickster something here so I remove a blocker. Then I think I want to dismember. So I want to dismember that one now. This so I can control the grists. Remember that you can't count that because it's a creature. It is a creature in addition. Wow, that's all in. What is he doing now? You may sacrifice. Okay, so now I trickster and choose the strength guy so it doesn't have undying. Then he can choose no, but I think I need to do it now. This is really bad for him. So if he chooses no, it's just being tapped. Now he can sacrifice that. He did. And can kill off one of the things. Now as Chris just dies, I think this is really good for us. And of course this one stays in two. I keep forgetting that, you know, Hexcat can't counter the grists. Oh, that's nice. It's really, really good. So we put in that one, say Merfolk. And now I think we should just put in the Lord, start beating face. No, let's just attack. We are in control. We are in control. Just take out the grists. And just hold up Aether Vial and Hexcatcher. So we can play both of them. And then we can activate a Mutavault sacking. So we have a lot of sacking we can do. No Rhyrog, that's fine. Don't hate it. And the Triarch's Messenger comes in tapped. That's fine. Now we're just gonna go all in with creatures here. Master in, and we're gonna put in a Hexcatcher. So now we can really grow these guys a lot. He conceded. And we can begin sideboarding. Okay, against these guys here, I think we like the Harbingers and we like the Subtleties. We actually like the Hearse as well. Productive Dismember. I don't think I like this. It's expected not that much. Cut the color of those. Can't do anything with the dark hand. Let's cut three more cards here. We can cut down a mimic, that's fine. Trickster's nice. We can cut down one of the lords. I like Harbingers because they have a lot of small things you can bounce. And we not need Tidesurfers to get unblockable. Maybe we'll just cut one Sphere Loom. It's a bit too slow in this matchup. Don't be too scared about cutting one or two Sphere Looms sometimes, because actually, look at this. You know, you don't want it in multiples, only if they have good ways of removing it. So we need to mulligan this because this does too little. This is much better. The reason why Unlicensed Hearse is good in this matchup, he's not asking us to discard anything, right? And we can take a Borrow back. The reason why Unlicensed Hearse is good is because you can activate it and target on the Undying trigger. We drew this Velo here. Playing a Taichi as a 1-1 is just so bad. He's gonna play a Wall of Roots next turn. I think it's better to hold it up and get unblockable. Next turn, I think I want to Trickster so he can resolve a Yawgmoth faster. This is not the best draw against Yawgmoth. He can even play a Grist now. Okay, it was a Wall of Roots, so you can see the Tideshaper. It would have been doing absolutely nothing. And now I think we can't stop the Yawgmoth now because of Twilight Mire. So what are we actually gonna do? We're probably just gonna play out a Master, right? Or the Unlicensed Hearse. Maybe it's good just get the Unlicensed Hearse out and into action. Or maybe we take out the Twilight Mire now from the Tideshaper. I actually like that line better. That might mean that he can't you know, generate enough black mana. Probably he can, but you know, we have to do something. I think this line gives us an out. That maybe he doesn't have a black source. And also, if it's like a Grist or something and he doesn't kill my Tideshaper, I can put down a Master and then I'm unblockable. Look at this. Look at this. He didn't have the black source. Now I need to get out the Hearse so the Sacred Geist can start working. I want to draw a Vial now. That would be a nice draw. We have something for player one. Do not draw the Vial. Maybe we just run out the Svealum. We run into Grist if we do, though. That's unfortunate. But he didn't have Grist. Then would he play Grist instead of playing that one? Let's just play out this Svealum. We don't want to attack here. Next turn we can double spell. This is just me trying to be mana efficient. I think we managed to deny him enough. Maybe there's a fail push or something coming in now, but I think, you know, playing as unlicensed Hearse and nothing else is such a bad line. If we get to untap with the Svealum, we are so far ahead. He found the black mana, so now I think the Yawgmoth comes in and now he goes off. So that's of course unfortunate, but I think, you know, he top picked that Verdant Catacomb. Seeing that he didn't have it before, I think it's the right line. If I knew he was to draw land, Grist comes in now. He did have the Grist, okay. Yeah. I should have played the Alistair's first. This backfired, but at least we can kill the Grists and resolve and... Oh, he did? That's funny. I think he chose the wrong one to destroy here, in my opinion. My humble opinion. Cavern is pretty okay. Maybe Merfolk. Put down a Master, so we are unblockable. Take off the Grist. Okay, he doesn't have anything, that's good. And now we can play down the Hearse, holding it up for the Undrying trigger. So this turned out alright. Only two cards in hand, and if it's not two good cards, then I'm satisfied. I don't know why he didn't sack the Strangle Geist for the Undying trigger. Now it's too late. So now the Unlicensed Hearse gives us value. Another thing with this deck I'm running here is that it's very low on graveyard interaction, which I don't like. I think we need at least two pieces of graveyard interaction. Calling Ritual. That's really good. Also because it works in the Grist. I mean, Strangle Geist. I could, of course, remove a couple of cards, but he doesn't really use his graveyard, so it's only against the Undying triggers. So that was a good Calling Ritual. Now we're pretty far behind. But that's what he got. So let's draw a Svealum from the top or something here. Oh, Lord. Okay, Lord is also nice. See what we can do. We can definitely play out a Lord. I want to do that. Okay, he's in top deck mode. I think I just want to tap down the Geist and go full aggressive. Noble Hierarch, yeah, that's nice. Because then I tap this one down. Guys, then he has no good attacks, and then we just go full aggressive. Hopefully draw more interaction now. What a perfect draw at this moment. Okay, drew a land. That's good for us. He can hit for 4, we go to 9. He does have the Blood Eyes. I want to draw a Trickster at some point. Let's get this Vital running. I wanted to get it to 2, so if we draw Adept next turn, then it's valuable. We can drain it to 3 and then hit us for 3. I don't think that's relevant yet. Okay, so he starts blocking now. Blood Eyes is not irrelevant in this matchup here, in this case. Battle Lincoln Short Moth. Oh my god, he drew a land. I gotta say that's of course pretty lucky. Go to 4 here. Need to draw something. What about a Trickster? Adept. Harbinger is perfect. I think it can be played at instant speed here. So he needs to block here. If he does block the Ignore Hierarch, we go to 3. Why is he taking that money now? Pride Arbor, that's really good. So go to 2 here. And then we just pass here. So he's in 1 card, and now he attacks us. Okay, Ignore Hierarch, that's a really annoying. If he didn't draw anything. We have to find a way of removing a threat or getting unblockable here. This is good because now this one goes to the hand. We can replay it now. So we need to find a Tidetaper to win. But if we do, we win. Tidetaper for the win. Tidetaper or Trickster for the win. That's not enough. No, so close. That's so annoying. There's so many outs. It's been some weird games against Yawgmoth. Just gonna pass and hopefully he does not attack. Or maybe only attack with the guys. Jesus. But again, as I we had some closer matchups than we normally do. Against Yawgmoth, so. I'm not complaining. Normally I just get, I can say, wrecked by Yawgmoth and needs to attack with the team. Only that one. That gives us a chance actually, that's pretty interesting. Because it's a 3-2. Okay. He did do a mistake. Because he expected my Harbinger to die here. And it didn't. So we never go to one. He should have attacked with... No, yeah, of course he couldn't do anything else. So that was actually a pretty nice draw. So we have a chance against the draw the Tide Shaper. Oh, we're in it. We are in it. Come on. Tide Shaper, one time. No. No Tide Shaper. Tide Shaper Trickster would have done it. That's so unfortunate. And he managed to do it. No! But this was fun. I'll put the deck list, old border magic card deck list. Oh, wait, we won one. Ooh. I thought I was losing. Of course, I was up 1-0. Did we miss this Fairloom maybe? No. It's okay. It was okay. That's really funny. I'm not over the moon thrilled about this, but it's not horrible either. You get to Harbinger early mana dork. It fits pretty poorly actually, but we get to dismember an early mana dork. Okay, 1-1. So close this game. That was fun. That was a fun game. Here comes the mana dork. Ooh, it's a young wolf. That's a good target to Harbinger at some point. I don't want to dismember it though. Maybe we just play down the Harbinger just as a 2-2. I think that's better. If I don't draw anything better, I think I'm going to do that. Do the subtlety. Yeah. Look at this guy coming in as 2-2 for 2. This is my bear. My bears are reals. So you can play down a mana dork. Strangled Root Geist. I don't want to counter that. Where's my Hearse at? Okay. We do have a line here. What if I just attack and he wants to block with the Geist and I buff it and then he has a 3-2? Is that good? I think it's fine. It's not good. It's fine. It's something to do with your life. So now he blocks with the Geist, right? No. He just takes it. Name an Elemental here, because if I draw a Mudaball or something, I still play the Salts next turn. Yeah, I don't want to counter a Birds. Maybe I'll dismember it. I think I'll dismember it. It looks like he's pretty bad on his mana.
What is he doing? What is he thinking?
Court of Calling! That's amazing! And I get to counter it. I love myself. This is so awesome. And yes, go away now. That's a pretty nice counter target. Okay, elemental is good. Yawgmoth is potentially next, so subtlety could be nice. I think I actually want to take the 3 points of damage here, holding up Harbinger and holding up subtlety. I'm going to 10, but it's not the race I'm worried about, it's Yawgmoth coming in. So I'm going to take the damage here. And I can bounce the string grass in any step. This might even be better because then he doesn't get to use his mana. Oh my god. There he is. Look at me being a genius. Go away now, Thran. Yawg, dude. It's a big tempo swing here. Subtlety on the Yawgmoth. Feels so good. And we go to our turn. Svelum, what a beauty of a draw. We can play both, but I think actually Harbinger is better. He bottomed the dude, okay. Harbinger is pretty nice because it's just gonna stall him out so much, putting the string grabs on top. And then I have Dismember up as well. Yes, please. It's actually been funny playing with Harbingers again. It's a decent effect. Now we start getting the pressure on. This is also because then Svelun is indestructible when it comes in. He drew a Tridopper. Yawgmoth again. Yes. As soon as I can, I'll dismember it. I'll do it now. We're gonna take some damage, but that's fine. I'm 6 HP. Scary. He did kill the Odell in his catcher. Which is okay. I understand it. Okay. But we do have a... it's not indestructible. I think I still want to attack with the subtlety here. Put down Svelun and we attack in the subtlety. Leaving the Harbinger back to block and the Svelun. Hopefully he doesn't have an answer to Svelun, but since he bottomed the Yawgmoth, I think that was pretty, you know, probably because he had the Yawgmoth. If he has a Grist, it's pretty bad for us, but we'll take it. Here comes the Geist. We knew that was coming. And another Geist. Yeah. So maybe we want to take us down to 3 here. Interesting line here. I think it's okay to do for him, and I absolutely understand the line. We need to draw something soon. That's pretty nice. I think this time around, I want to keep the subtlety back to block, but I want to get this Svelun up and running. So let's just play this one out first. We want to attack with this one. We'll have to draw something. Ooh, Harbinger is perfect. Perfect again. It's not, you know, perfect, but it's pretty good. We're gonna play it out now. Merfolk. Just so we have an indestructible. And so we can deny mana a bit on the string of geists. And we say yes to bouncing it. This game has been pretty long. 4 HP, he's on 5 HP, pretty tight. But we have 3 blockers. And I think the Harbinger can block the Strangle Geist. That's fine, we'll trade it there. Look at all this. Old Borsvin. I guess I actually like this card. I have one of them in paper, I need to have all of them in paper. Okay, here comes the Geist again. It's annoying for him, he has to replay that. And another Geist. Okay. So, he maybe needs to stop attacking. Yeah, that makes more sense. If he wants to attack, he should attack with all. Because the Dry Lava can block the Svealoon. But look at this. He gotta block the Svealoon, and I can attack with the Subtlety as well. So this is cheating me a bit here. We got this game. So look at this, we can do block, take 3. What if he plays black mana and that little thing there? How many attacks do we need? Just one more, right? What if I do like this? Then I still have 3 attackers. I like this better, this is a bit more safe. He might have 2 blockers next turn. Oh, I need to stay this alive with this one. Blockers. So I only attack with Svealoon again. We have 4 blockers now. He also goes to 1. Was that stupid? Yeah, that was bad. Okay. We should attack with the Subtlety, I think. Because then he was forced to block the Svealoon. But that wouldn't have changed it. Damn. No! I should have traded it there. Oh, misplay. Okay. Unfortunate. No, we die. GG, we peep. I'm sad, but it was a decent leak. Thanks for watching. And as always, remember, if you like the content, you can look more into it. Have my all my content placed at my YouTube channel, youtube.com/Draco. And thanks for watching. We'll be right back next time with more Merfolk action. See you there.